Hello class, today I'm going to be talking about a pair of viral videos. One commercial campaign created by a company or brand to spread the word. It was targeted, focused, planned out. And the other video was an accidental, more organic video that really didn't have any expectations, but then exploded to become viral, to be shared through social networking sites and other sites all over the internet. So to begin, I like to kind of preface by saying we'll be focusing on two things that I believe really make a good viral video, and based on some of the readings that we had. There's a lot of other factors, but these two I really, especially for these two videos, can end on is emotion. I think, even not playing with people's emotions, but kind of hindering onto people's emotions and using that as a factor is really effective. For example, using humor, kind of lining up somebody's day, so playing with their emotions. And the other one is kind of giving people something to do with what they saw on the video. For example, I hope I get her name right, but in the New York Times article that was posted in class by Natalie Kitroff, it was titled "Why That Video Went Viral." One of the quotes was, "Gives the user something to do with it." So after they watch it, it could be like a catchphrase or something like that, and they feel inclined to do something, whether it's like funny or humorous, which is a great way to spread the message. It kind of goes along with that more interactive aspect of videos. You know, you can just watch it and be like, "Eh, whatever," but if you watch it and it gives you something like that sticks in your head, it gives you something that you can actually do, and it kind of uses your emotions, I think that's really good for a video to become viral out of one of the many other factors. So for my two examples, for the commercial example, I know this is pretty old and I'll play it. It's the "Was Up" by the Budweiser. And it was basically a campaign used by Budweiser to kind of help market and spread, you know, the message of Budweiser, to use it for marketing campaigns, and basically to become a household name. And what they did, they tried to create a slur, which actually they did very well. This went viral. There was people doing this everywhere. It was very unique. It was funny, which is great because people say, "Oh, that's really funny. Where did you hear that from?" And then they would refer to this Budweiser commercial. So they attached their name to something that people were doing, you know, at school, at work, and fun. And by doing this, it also kind of branches out to other mediums, too. I know, like, for example, in an episode of The Simpsons, they had this. In some movies, they made fun of this. So people will hear that and be kind of curious where it came from. And they can associate Budweiser with something that is funny, unique, basically very... It gets stuck in your head. But anyways, here's a commercial. Sure, I know this came out 8 years ago, but it was a great example of a video going viral. And also using that kind of spreadable media, which is, you know, to motivate and affect kind of fans to spread the word. Based on, you know, it being funny. So here's a video.
Hello.
Hello.
Yo, what's up? Nothing, B. Just watching the game, having a bud. So but you?
Nothing.
Watching the game, having a bud.
True.
What's up? What's up?
Yo, what's up?
Yo, you pick up the phone.
Hello.
What's up?
What's up?
Where's Duke?
Yo, Duke.
Yo.
Hello?
Hello?
So what's up, B?
What's up, B?
Watching the game, having a bud. True. True.
I think that is a really funny and a good example of a video kind of crossing into other platforms, other mediums, you know, just being commercial, but it spread really well on the internet, and as I mentioned before, in movies and TV shows, it kind of made reference to it. I think a very important aspect, as I mentioned earlier, was the catchphrase on that really caught on. You know, it's easily recognizable, so if a lot of people, you know, if a lot of people do it, then more people are going to be wondering, and then more people are going to be checking out, you know, the video, and which was a great campaign to kind of spread the name brand of Budweiser. You know, people know it's a beer, but it kind of separates it from others in the term of this video going viral. And obviously, was it effective? Yes, it was very effective, just based on all the attention that they got. I know a lot of people are very familiar with this, so I think it was definitely successful. So on to my next one. Sorry, just looking at a few notes here that I jotted down, but based on emotion, I know this is the more accidental, more organic video. It's very, I guess, raw and dry cut. It was a young man in his room using a webcam. Webcam was very grainy, very raw, and singing the song called Numa Numa, which, you know, if people listen to, it's kind of upbeat, catchy. So I'll play it, and then I'll explain the reasons why I thought it became very popular, how it kind of hinged onto the viewer's emotions and make that play a part, and people, you know, becoming more, you know, kind of excited, in a better mood, and as some of the reasons explained, is when people are kind of in a good mood, they want to share something like this, because they're excited when they see it, if they laugh, you know. So here it is, the Numa Numa. Play it really briefly.
Și te rog, iubirea mea, primește fericirea. Alo, 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 sunt eu, Picasso, ți-am dat beat. Și sunt voinic, dar să știi, nu-ți cer nimic. Vrei să pleci, dar nu mă
So as I mentioned before, this video, along with the other video, it gives you something that you can actually do. What I mean by that is, for example, his dancing, his kind of mannerisms and maneuvers. The viewer sees it, and, you know, they can kind of do it themselves and replicate it. For example, that dance, I've seen a bunch of people do that, you know, with their hands in the air, and, you know, at school, at work, and anywhere, basically. So, if you can entice people to kind of do something, and also, I love it because, as I mentioned before, it's very raw. For example, it's just his webcam, and it's just somebody just having fun. Kind of not caring, very, very free-spirited. It's kind of, you know, if you're in a bad mood, you can watch this and kind of become, you know, in a better mood. It'll lighten you up. And it's very, very, and it's not too long either, which is the great thing, along with this and the other one. And they're about a minute. This one's a minute 30. So you can share it, you can view it multiple times, and it'll keep your attention, along with the song being pretty catchy. So, this video spread everywhere. I remember on Facebook, there's people downloading the song, they listen to the song, and then they would refer back to this video. So, this video does a great job of using your emotions, you know, in a more playful way. Kind of making you come in a better mood, and it also, it gives you something to do with the video. People can copy it, they can do the dance, replicate it, and they can go out, and which is a great way to spread the word. And also, this also comes along with the idea of this stickiness, as said in our reading, it kind of holds the attention of the viewers. You know, you just want to keep watching it, because it is funny, and it really gives you something, you know, to kind of, basically, it's very lighthearted. So, for the more organic video that went viral, I chose Numa Numa. And for the more commercial, was the Was Up by Budweiser. It was targeted for an audience, an older audience, but at the same time, it created a catchphrase that other people can use. And along with this video and the other video, they could be used in different medias and different mediums, like for TV shows. I know there was a lot of people who made kind of made fun of it, but in a good way, in a commercial way, in a funny way. You know, both these ones have been on different TV shows. They span through different movies. Just the people using the catchphrase and doing the dance. So both these were very successful. Yeah, and these are the two videos that I decided to choose for the campaign video and the more organic accidental video.